We are just waiting for the live feed to come through before we can go live. Now we're up. That's it. Right, we'll try again. I'll pop out the chat. Where are we? There we go. Get this up on Facebook and then we're up and running.
Yeah. Yes. Hopefully. So up and running.
Alright. Let's go.
Let's go. Every show on for now on.
That will be funny.
Yeah, just beginning the show like this. That would be funny.
So, after our technical difficulties and having to restart and the camera's there. Hopefully, we're running now.
And we've got Mr. Vibe headset with us.
We are going to have a rundown of three space exploration games, experiences, whichever you like to call them.
Expectations of what you like want to happen.
Yeah.
You don't expect what's going to happen. Might or not be true, but hopefully you have a good time in them. And he can be talking while we're playing, but just before we start, we're playing Times of Space, Discovering Space, and Space Tours Episode 1.
I'll just wait over here, shall I?
And I'm going to be playing Times of Space and Space
You're
Wars.
Going to be playing, you're actually, I'm going to let you play all of them because the amount of technical difficulties that we're having, I seem to be having to be right by a computer permanently to sort it out. And I don't want things going wrong if I'm inside the VR. So you're going to be the lucky one to play all three games, even though one of them he has never seen. So this will be new for him.
Yeah.
Right, bung your headset on. Let's not waste any more time. Right, now the problem with one of these, which is this one, Titans of Space, is you have to be in an exclusive window, which means I have to turn everything off here, so we won't see nothing. And I have to adjust the volume so it'd be quiet and all this stuff. I wish I had a second monitor. Mind you, if I had a second monitor, it wouldn't have worked. So, without further ado, we'll swap over to Titans of Speed. Right, let me just get the volume correct. Yep, down a bit. There we go. And off you go, mister.
When this starts... There we go.
There you go. You've got to sit forward, that's it, and then pull your triggers when you're ready. Right, we're going to do the short tour, aren't we? Because then we can go through them without completely boring everybody, and also people can find out and explore at their own leisure. So with this one, you get to sit in like a little mini spaceship of your own. You can choose, obviously, as you've seen, a long tour or a short tour. You can have it completely interactive, or you can just put the things down and have it on autopilot. This is quite old now. I think this is about a year old. But it's very good. Quality-wise, I like the graphics on there. It's nice and realistic-y. You get a good sense of size with the planets comparison, so you know it definitely looks like
real life.
The sun's big. So
look at that.
Yeah, and it's full of facts everywhere. So off you go, start the tour, click ready and autopilot, and all your gunk and info will come up on the little monitor in front of you, so you can...
Right there!
Yeah. You can fly around.
There's Venus, the next one we're going to go up to.
Yeah, we'll look...
If that was the moon, it would be a new moon. Or whichever side you Venus. The Mercury, its diameter is 4.
Right, click on ready again.
Ready?
Yeah, and then click autopilot. Right, that should send you on the way now.
Look at that.
So really, you don't have, there's no like atmospherics in this game. It's a piece of music playing. Rather nice piece of music, but go on, let's carry on. And see, if we sat here and like went through the entire tour, reading all the entire facts, number one, you wouldn't need to go and get the game to have a look yourself or to find out everything yourself, and we don't want to overdo the live stream.
Yeah.
So it'll seem like we're hastily going through it, but you know, it's just to get an overview of what's happening.
And I'm just going to be probably showing you all of the planets only. I'm not going to read all the facts to you, but I'm going to read a few of them.
Click ready.
And next.
You love using the zoom button, don't you?
Yeah, zoom.
Don't make anybody sick. They haven't got an headset on.
Yeah. He's healing sick already.
Yeah.
I'll do this last one.
Go on then, moving on. The detail is rather remarkable.
And this does look 3D. There's one of its moons. Wow, I nearly fell off the chair there. Look at that.
Having a little zoom in on Jupiter, oh yes, the clouds are moving.
Great red spot. Look at that.
Is it amazing?
There's all of
go
that.
On.
Next. Now what do you got? So now we're already here, and there's a bit more to this. Now that we're a little bit scared to hell after Uranus and Neptune. At least I think it's on this one. Yeah, it's on this one.
I think you might find it isn't.
There's Saturn. Uranus, I'm just telling
you. No, you're sat on it. So.
That's not a real.
That's done.
If this is for a new form of Mercury, maybe. Now. Look at that. It's
kind of silly. See, it's actually. It's actually a rather enjoyable experience, isn't it? What does it last? About half an hour? 40 minutes? I mean, you could spend up to like 2 hours on it if you went through all the information and all the details. You could go through everything, couldn't you?
After this one.
Yeah. Well, we're going to come out of this one now.
Well, I'll probably end it after here because at the end. People really start to get sick. At least I think.
And why would they start to get sick?
I need my eyes. Because you get too many suns. Or should I say stars? Look at that. Look at that. Look at that.
Right, so what we do, we come out of this one.
And now, I really don't want to do this.
And I've got to wait for the keyboard. Yeah, people, don't get a Bluetooth keyboard. Especially one that isn't going to work. Oh, can you use the Steam menu and close? Oh, we're in. Well, I'd say we're in.
Yeah.
Everything's going nuts.
Yeah.
as per usual. Right.
I really wanted to get the
sun. Now the mouse has gone. I tell you what, tonight is an absolute waste of time. When it has to go wrong, when it has to go right, everything goes wrong, and then when we're practicing, there's no problems. And it. Yes, Dad. Home slice.
Yeah.
Closing the window. Ta-da!
I really wanted to get to the other stars part.
Now we know why people edit their videos. Is this working? Yes.
Okay.
Right, so what are we playing next?
So now we're going to go to Discovering Space.
Discovering Space. Whoosh. There we go.
And we're going to probably be in that soon.
Now this one's not so bad because...
In normal, so is he.
There's
no zooming in on this one. So if you felt sick on the first one, you probably won't feel sick on the next one. I'll do free flight.
Hit me. Well, we're not in yet. This one's eager. He loves his space. He does like his space. So right. Discovery Space. Now, this one I like. This is probably my favourite one. So without wasting too much time, we'll jump straight into that one. Do the tours, because you can do a couple of mini tours. We'll just do one or two of the tours, and I'll let you, Home Slice, you can pick your two tours.
First, need to get the tours. I'll do free flights.
You don't need free flight, go back.
Look at this. Aww, I don't want to do free flight.
Go back and do the tours. And then pick yourself a tour.
Finding Apollo,
okay. Now this one, we're going to have you travelling to the moon, is it? Yes, travelling to the moon.
Yeah, and Dad, I really want to do free flight. After the show, can I do free flights?
Maybe after the show. Are we waiting for things to load now?
Load, all the way to Apollo, load, all the way to Apollo.
Well, let's hope Apollo. It takes quicker to load than it takes to get to Apollo.
Yeah! A good point.
Yes.
Because I want to get in the game more than go to Apollo.
It shouldn't take this one to do.
No.
There we go.
Desert.
Now this one you do get a real sense of being in space.
I got these on the wrong hands. And that's it. Left and the moon is dead ahead. And this is real. Accelerating to around 4% of the speed of light, we will make the journey in a fraction of the time. Dad, please, may we go out the ship?
I can't remember how we do it.
We played this like 2 days ago.
I know.
I can't believe you can't remember.
I know. I also do, it was on a controller. Let me get the controller.
Oh, I don't know. They are flat regions formed from cooled lakes of volcanic lava during the early formation of the moon. I don't know what this is. These flat regions make ideal targets for attempting a lunar landing. The large region in the center is called the Sea of Tranquility, with the Sea of Crises to the right and the Sea of Serenity at the top. Look at that. There we go, now we're out of the ship.
A As we approach closer, we can start to see the more mountainous and crated terrain surrounding these darker regions.
Look at the moon. Look at real that is.
Look at that.
It looks amazing, doesn't it?
And there wasn't really a person outside the ship.
That was me.
Look at that. A large crater.
The Sea of Crises is dead ahead.
Oops.
You can hear the chatter of the Apollo astronauts as they orbited the moon in preparation for their landing. We will swing around to the left and line ourselves up with the Apollo approach.
Absolutely amazing. And you'd think that you'd lose detail the closer, because, or you think you're looking at a picture, but as you get closer, the detail gets better and better. This one doesn't realise how much he's laying down.
No, because I'm five. I don't know what this does.
Nor do I. Does it actually feel like you're flying by the moon?
Yeah. Maybe it just compares size. So it's tiny.
Well, let's get rid of the glowy ball things and concentrate on the moon.
We can use that after the show.
Yeah.
Does that show what it does and we could do this again? Big creep.
Come on, turn that off.
The smoother terrain of the Sea of Tranquility, dead ahead, looks much more ideal.
What sea? There's no sea!
And what's that?
A crescent earth! The crescent earth!
Yeah.
Like the crescent moon, but earth.
He's definitely trying to make people sick.
We are heading for a region just before the hills ahead.
We have to find the puddle.
I shall let you wander. Look at him. I shall get a drink of water.
We are around 100 kilometers above the landing site, and we will gently swing around to the left and reduce altitude.
Look at that.
How amazing does it look?
Altitude 85 kilometers.
Look! I didn't know you could do this!
How close to the ground are you now?
Ow! That's got to hurt.
Can we look at the moon?
We will slow our descent with our vertical thrusters.
Oh, yeah! I don't know that this Look, see everything.
50.
Underneath the ship. I like this view a lot better. Go on. I'm going to the outside view. Over to the outside view.
All of the instruments and experiments have been left intact.
Oh, this is better. Look at that. I'm trying to go behind it.
I don't know.
I want to go behind it. I want to go behind it. Because then you can see.
But if you get back into the ship, you can see. It's a rather good feeling, isn't it? It's like you're actually in the spaceship on the moon.
That was close. Let's head away before we do some damage.
And then you can actually land, can't you?
With the thrusters on our ship, we can move around much more easily than the early
landers. Come on, Dad, I want to go outside, behind me. Come on. Come on, Dad. You're in front. This is going to make lots of people sick.
Not the smoothest of approaches, but at least we are down.
Where's the pro?
Let's try again and see if we can get closer.
I don't know how you moved yourself over to that position, but there you go. So you can't see nothing there. You can see better from there.
That's better.
Make sure you do no damage. You gonna go back to your position?
Touchdown.
We are touchdown.
The earth is visible directly above us.
You must try to keep still. Okay?
Look at that.
Yeah. People can't see a picture if you're jiggling your head all over the place.
Let's take off vertically as they would have done when returning to Earth for the first time. 20 meters.
Come on, do the outside behind. Come on.
100.
No.
200, 300, 400, 500, 1,000.
Let's
use our main thrusters to accelerate away and get back to Earth quicker.
Go on behind. Go on, dude. Behind.
Well, then we're going to go back to Earth.
I want to see the thrusters on the back working. Come on.
Trust the kid.
I'm in front of it now. Behind the planes. Behind the planes.
Oh, wow, they're looking at us going away from the moon. Look at the moon getting smaller.
It didn't take this long to actually get back to Earth.
How long does it take them to get back to Earth normally?
About 3 to 4 days. Earth days, actually. Nearest.
So whereabouts in Earth are you now? I'm getting closer. So that is...
I went nowhere in Earth. I went not anywhere.
That is discovering space. The other tours... just as in depth, just as wonderful graphics, aren't they? Absolutely gorgeous. The sense of, this is the one that is most being there, I think.
This is the end of the tour.
Isn't it? Absolutely fantastic. Right, so we'll come out of there. I'll get the keyboard going again. There we go. And tweak.
Come on.
Yeah, we'll close that one.
And we said two.
That's two, and now we're going to the last one, which is
Space Tours 2. to what I am.
Space Tories.
Episode 2.
Yes.
And I'm going to be further back for this one.
Now this one, because it stretches the screen, or it's only half a screen, there's no way I can get that to stretch over here. So it's going to have to stay there.
And
this is about the best we can get. Have you got a stand on this one?
Yeah.
Okay.
I think it's better off you just moving the camera a bit further.
You reckon?
Yeah.
Well, you go and stand where you're meant to and I'll move the camera. Right, I'll move that over this way a bit. There you go. Give you a bit of room. And then I come over here. Rob your place. Do we have sound?
No, I don't hear anything in this one.
Okay. Let's have a look. Another one that needs an exclusive window.
Yeah, stay what's down. Yeah?
Okay.
Why do
you know? Why is that doing that? What is happening?
Yeah, why do you want me to do it?
If it was possible for everything to go bleeding wrong, it will. Right, I think you have to hold on to the handles. So you're standing up in a pod thing, yeah, hold on to that and hold on to that. There you go. You actually can't, can you? Yeah, you can cheat if you want to.
Why did you do that?
I didn't do anything, that was you.
Dad!
What?
I had to go back in the spaceship thingy.
Well, compress the shell then. Is it not letting you?
No.
Well, if you look down, you're standing on a platform, so you're perfectly fine.
No, I want to get back in.
You are in!
I'm not inside it!
It's a glass dome! You're in a glass dome, that's all. You alright now?
No! Dad! I want to go back in!
Well, click on warp.
Yeah? Yeah?
You don't know what to do, do you? Click on one of them planets then, or point to one of them planets. Well, you're already at Earth, so you don't want to go to Earth, do you? You're already there. Try Mars or something. Yeah, our space station's down there. International Space Station. Can you point to it? Hey, I'll grab and release objects.
Yeah?
Yeah? Can you see the International Space Station on Earth?
Yeah.
Or point at it?
Yeah.
Have you got your little laser thing come up? Can you point to the space? There you go. You're sitting on the floor. What are you sitting on the floor for?
I'm really scared.
Would you like me to do it?
No.
I'm scared. I've got to sit on the floor. Do you want me to do it? No.
You said I could do all three, so I'm going to do all three. And Dad, can we actually do three flights in this episode?
I don't know. I don't think you can do it in this game. I think you're going to do a...
I mean, in Discovering Space.
Oh, after?
Yeah, and can we do it in this video?
No.
Aww. I want to go and see what it's like.
People have fallen asleep. Right. Now, in all fairness, point at objects to start events. So see what you can do with pointing and clicking. You'll see them, they've got circles around them, yeah? So see that planet over there?
Yes.
Yeah, point at it. There you go. Now you've got to stand up, you've got to put it into your warp meter.
What? Oh, Dad?
Yeah?
Do you mean we're gonna just teleport to Mars?
Yeah.
And we're not gonna fly?
No, you won't fly because the cage will come up.
Is it gonna fly?
But you've got to stand up because...
I can't.
You've got to put... Yes, you've got to put the planet up there on the pedestal.
What's
wrong? Stand up, there you go. You can stand up now, you're back in your little pod. Stand up! You have to stand up because you've got to hold on to the poles. There you go. You have to...
Sit down now.
I wish you could see him. I might actually...
Come on!
You're there! Just stand up!
Yeah. No! No!
You gotta stand up because you gotta click the button. There you go.
No.
Oh, satellite.
No, I don't.
Don't you like that one?
No, I don't like this. I don't like this.
Well, turn around because you've got to look at Mars.
No.
You've got to find there it is.
Turn away and just look at Mars. Like there's nothing even here.
You spin around on the floor. I don't get it. I don't get it because you just sat in a spaceship flying across the solar system, right? And all you said was, "Put me outside the ship. Put me outside the ship. I want to be outside the ship." And I kept putting you outside the ship. Now you're outside the ship, and it's like, I've got to sit on the floor.
Dad.
Go on, Emma, let's find another planet for you. So we're going over Boochers at. You got one over there.
Saturn.
Is it Saturn? You sure?
Yeah, it's got rings.
Well, so's Uranus. So's Jupiter.
Not as thick as that.
Uh-huh.
I think we should end this episode here.
Okay. Off you go. What are you doing?
Hey, look, it's staying in space.
They can't see you. Right, point Saturn then.
No.
And then we'll turn it. Well, if not, I'll have to take it off you.
Okay.
Am I doing this one then?
You can do the rest.
Okay. You take them. You sit here and talk to the people. Because don't forget, we are live.
Yeah, I know that.
So I've got to change this setting for me.
Yeah.
Change the headset. I'm sorry about the picture going all over the place, but I've got to change the
headset.
The headset for me. Right, is it my left hand?
Yeah. Come on.
Okay, I'm there. Right, thank you.
Yeah. And the one you're holding right now, still have the strap on me.
Thank you.
So, get ready. On.
See, now we're actually travelling around Mars, aren't we?
No. Strap.
Yes.
Zip. Hold. Done.
You can sit there.
I'm sat there.
I'll go and stand on the pedestal thingy.
Chop, chop.
in the shop.
Okay, so
we're
back.
Here we go.
So he's going to travel to Saturn now.
Am I?
Well,
Spacers, we are being my shell for. Okay, I don't know what satellite that is. Oh, it's opening.
I'm sorry about the picture.
Is that because it needs some sun? Yes. Oh, very clever.
Yeah, very clever.
Very detailed as well, I like that.
Yeah?
All these games are very detailed.
I'll probably be talking to you, but not.
Now, where's the
IHC? Oh, to Saturn.
Point objects. Okay. Hey, let's go to here.
He's now in rocket! Remember, hold on to pop bombs,
things! Yeah. I'm just calling up. Oh, I can't. I'm calling up the VR wire. That's it. Right, so, hold on. Hold on.
In an environment already? No.
Why is it not doing anything? I'm holding on. There we go.
Look at that.
That does look cool.
Now, listen.
Are there satellites on every single one of these?
The button!
I'm pressing
the blue button. Just slap it.
Here we go.
We're not going to be in the picture, but it's away. Yeah, there's satellite. There's satellite on that one.
These things do things. Uh-huh.
And in this game, please leave a big thumbs up if I was better.
Now I see. These are the moons. More
satellites.
Yeah, wow, look at that.
Oh my god, it's only for this game, not the other two, because you would definitely say yes, because I was the only one playing them.
Just out of curiosity, or just for a little fact-based thingy, if you, I don't know if you can see the laser, that dark ring there, you've got the outer ring and you've got this black line separating two. There's actually one of Saturn's moons.
Yeah.
We're inside that little black part.
Yeah.
There you go.
There is. It's called Pan. And there's Titan.
I've got Mr. Stephen Hawking's there.
What do you mean?
Huh?
What do you mean,
Dad? You certainly know what's what about space, don't you? Right, where should we go now?
Yeah.
Can we have a look at the sun? Oh, we can. Oh, wow. Let's go and have a look at the sun.
Hold.
Shoot.
Wow! See, when we're back at the sun!
Solar.
Mercury.
I didn't say Mercury. Since when did the sun look like Mercury?
It's probably because Mercury rolls right in front of the sun.
That is bright. I'm assuming that that's going to block Mercury out. I can sort it off, yeah, with the controller. I need two controllers here.
If that's the sun,
then
underneath is Mercury.
See that? Oh, there's Mercury.
What an embarrassment, sort of. Sometimes I'm not going to be in the camera because I'm looking.
So really, this is like a visually based, isn't it? Visual based.
I'll be back in a second.
So,
so the galaxy.
I can see, yeah, you've got there, obviously, our Milky Ways. Everything's
quite correct. Big and quite big.
Yeah, everything's correct in here. So, what we'll do is. I think we've sort of done enough about space now. We'll come out of here.
Yeah.
And we'll come out of the ride.
Before anyone gets sick, as they were.
Yeah. Well, there you go. Shift over. That's a quick overview of three space games. Hopefully you got what you wanted from them, but
and hopefully you want three five.
Yeah, where's the keyboard?
If I'm really good, better than Dad, and if you want to see three flight. But if you just want to do one,
well, we may do one another time tomorrow or something. Yeah. They'll just do it as a live stream and leave it as a this thing's not working now. Right. This is all guesswork because I don't have a mouse now. There we go. I cannot see anything. I can't click. Oh, why has it done that? The computer's gone wrong.
Yeah, the word. Do not buy.
Don't buy a PC. Don't buy Windows 10.
Yeah, and also don't even buy
I've got no mouse now, the Bluetooth's gone altogether.
Section Ica TV.
I've tried to hurry up, but the computer's gone down again. Alright, now you've got a mouse. Alright, I'm turning this off. I'm gonna end this live stream.
I can't find my iPod. This is the worst.
You cannot find my iPod.
Yeah.
Ever.
Probably won't be doing any more live streams.
We have to get money.
What?